Yeah, you know, Don, you said that this meeting was embarrassing. I think, quite frankly, what's embarrassing is the condescension that you've shown to Kanye West, someone who I think is a brave and independent thinker, a creative genius. Does he speak in a different vernacular? Of course he does. Like a lot of artists, it's a vernacular I don't necessarily always understand, but I do understand that he's a great thinker. And for you and a lot of your guests to dismiss him as a, quote, token Negro and to question his mental stability when you're not doctors, when you haven't examined him, I think is really unfortunate. And it's an example, unfortunately, that is all too common on the left, which is liberals, when a minority doesn't toe the party line.
By the way, the person who said that comment that you said the token Negro thing is a conservative. But go on.
Well, not in my mind. She's not a conservative. But let me also tell you this, more to the point, which I think is really what's important
here. She didn't call him a token
Negro.
She says all of a sudden now he is the token Negro for the Trump administration.
Right. Talking about him. Right.
Yeah.
Now, to Charles's point about does this president care about minorities, let me tell you my personal experience with him in that very same Oval Office without cameras present. All he wanted to know about from me is, what can I do for the Hispanic community? What can we do for growth in your community? I said, well, one thing you can do right now, let's send a tweet. And then let's talk about more long-term things that we can do about the community. So he absolutely cares whether the camera's on or off. But Kanye West is a person who speaks from the heart. You call it a rant. You always say this in your Chiron. You editorialize. It's not a rant to me. And as a matter of fact, it was inspirational. I don't find him unstable. I find him creative. I find him inspiring. And in that room, you had three people, an amazing artist, an amazing athlete, and an amazing builder, all saying, what can we do in the political process to make the prosperity and security of America broader into minority communities? That's
right.
A great
Please
thing
finish.
For this country. Jim Brown, Kanye
Please
West,
finish.
Donald Trump are visionaries. They are great men trying to help this country.
I just don't have the energy tonight because there's so much in there
let me just,
to
let me just
come
tell
on.
You, but let me just point out a little bit of
there
hypocrisy.
Is so much because that's how
let
much this president
a little bit
is doing
about
for minority.
How conservatives
that is nothing
treat
to,
this, right?
I'm not even going to go ahead.
Right?
Go ahead.
So you remember when Barack Obama was quoting Jay-Z and Michelle Obama said that if she wanted to be like somebody, she wanted to be like Beyonce. They searched through every lyric they had and tried to tell us how these were not geniuses. These were not honorable people. These were horrible people.
Yeah.
Rappers have rapper lyrics. Kanye has rapper lyrics.
Can I read some for
you? Now all of a sudden, he is the paragon of moral virtue and he's a genius.
Yeah.
I'm not saying we should be downing any rapper. I'm just saying these conservatives do this thing, right? If liberals like him, if President Obama likes him, that is the spawn of Satan. When Common performed at the White House, they literally went through every one of Common's songs to find lyrics that they found offensive and said, this is why Obama should not have this
Charles,
man at the White House.
That's not
and
fair
now
to me.
All of a sudden,
I'll
we come
tell
out like, oh, he's a genius.
Let me tell you
something.
No,
Kanye hasn't had a genius
time.
Record since graduation in 2007, and you can check me on that. I like Kanye. You put out good music, make your music, brother. And also, don't say that we are saying that Kanye has a mental problem. Kanye
is
constantly telling us that Kanye has a mental problem. Therefore, I don't want to talk about Kanye.
No, so
it wasn't Kanye's problem that he was in the Oval Office.
No,
it
you said
Donald
it was an
Trump's
unstable rant
today.
And it was not, in my view, at all.
Well,